Friends, this time we are going to discuss another taught topic called as false imprisonment. False imprisonment. This means wrongful imprisonment. You all know what is imprisonment. Putting a person in jail is called imprisonment, literally or legally or generally. But here, false imprisonment means confining a person to any place for any point of time, maybe a 1 minute, maybe a 1 second also. Any point of time, it amounts to false imprisonment because it is against to the fundamental principles, fundamental rights of Article 21 of the Constitution of India. Nowadays, previously also, the English law says nobody should be abjected in his movement, nobody should be obstructed, nobody should be confined, nobody should be restrained in his movements. He should have a peaceful, safe passage. Of course, since Constitution has come, I am referring to Article 21 of the Constitution, Life and Liberty. So, in this connection, Justice Blackstone, he says, every confinement of a person is an imprisonment, whether it be in a common prison, is quite common, then private house or in a public street also. So, you cannot ask a person, come on, you stay here, you cannot go back till you pay my money, like that, you cannot do that. So, this is called false imprisonment. In English law, it is otherwise called as residuary trespass. So, even the assault, battery, all these things are trespass to the persons. Trespass to land, we will discuss in other way. Sic utitur utulinium. You enjoy the property without interfering with others. I will tell you later, not now. Right? So, if you want to file a criminal case, it comes under section 340 of the Indian Penal Code. Whoever restrains any person, please remember two words, restrainment and confinement. Restrainment means stopping a person, asking him to not to go further. This is restraint. Suppose confining a person means keeping a person in a room, locking it from outside and going away. That is confinement. Both of them in tort law, they are called as the false imprisonment. Now, as per section 340 APC, whoever restrains any person to prevent him from proceeding further, he will be liable for 1 year imprisonment. Wrongful confinement already. Yesterday I told you that the person has to take a warrant from the magistrate, then only he can go to the room and release the confined persons. Now we'll quickly go to the case laws. Bird versus Jones, most important case. Bird versus Jones, 1845. Right. What happened is, Mr. Jones, of course, he was holding some, he was a businessman. Actually, every year he conducts the rowing competitions, just like our rowing competitions in Kerala state. So, for this, he has to arrange some fencing, some barricading, some chase, all these things. So, for this purpose, he has occupied the public footpath also. So, this was there in 1845. Normally, nowadays, we cannot see any footpaths in even in urban places also. So, in 1845 itself, he occupied the public pathway and he has constructed the so-called barricading and arranged some chairs and he has put some tokens or tickets. Then he is allowing the persons, whoever has purchased the tickets, he is asking them to occupy the seats. Our friend, Mr. Bird, he went there and he has picked up a quarrel with him actually. How the quarrel has taken place? Our man went to the backside and he has climbed the so-called barricading and he was peeping through the rowing competition. Then this man said, "Arey Baba, you get on. You go to some other place, not here, because this place is meant for the persons who purchase the tickets. Get on." This man said, "No, no, you have already occupied the public carriageway or public pathway, then why you are asking me about the ticket or the thing?" He said, no, I have done something. I have taken permission from the corporation. I am doing this. If you are able to purchase ticket, okay, you go and sit here. Otherwise, you get down and go to the other place from where you can see. It is difficult for me to see. Well, then he did not agree. Ultimately, by using certain force, he has asked him to made him climb down. So, annoyed by this, he filed a case of tort. So, the House of Lords, they did not agree because it is the duty of the contractor to pull him down. To pull him down because he did not purchase the ticket. So, So since it is therefore it is not held to be a case of false imprisonment. It is only for half an hour. That too, there was no total restraint. So he was able to see even from that place also. Therefore, or otherwise, as suggested by the defendant, the plaintiff is burned. He has taken some other way. He has gone to some other way, and he should have seen the rowing competition. Right? So it is not false imprisonment. It is a negative example. Now we'll go to other case. Me versus Krukshank, Krukshank, 1902. Right? Here what happened is, so the plaintiff was an under trial prisoner. He attended the court on so many adjournments. Ultimately, on the final day, the judgment was in his favor. That means the case ended in acquittal. Now what they have to do? They are supposed to do. They are supposed to, actually the prison authorities, they are supposed to give him back all his belongings, all the money he earned during the term of jail, and send him or bid him by. That's all. So they should not wait, they should not make him wait. But instead of that, the Krukshank, the warden, he has taken him to downside one of the cells and detained him there for a few minutes and put him some questions, some embarrassing questions. Ultimately, after half an hour, he was allowed to go away. So now he filed a case of false imprisonment, and the court held it, yes, definitely it's a case of false imprisonment. As the time doesn't matter. In the beginning I told you, maybe 1 minute or maybe two, time doesn't matter. What matters is the liberty or the restraint on the liberty of an individual. So a person should not be unlawfully restrained, maybe for a few minutes, not allowed. So it's a case of false imprisonment. Another good case, John Lewis and Co. versus Timms, 1952. So this Timms, she's a lady, she along with her daughter, they went into the shop, John Lewis and Co. for purchasing something. They went there, they were doing shopping, but this girl has got the bad habit of stealing something. The girl stole some articles in the shop and put them or dropped them in the bag of her mother. But the store shop, they were smart enough. They detected the same, but anyway, since they are ladies, they could not do anything. They asked them to wait in the lounge for about half an hour or so. So this woman asked, as to why you are asking it? Wait. Then the police came and took both of them to the police station. They conducted the inquiry. The inquiry revealed that the daughter, cunningly, she stole the material and dropped it in the mother's bag, which the mother actually does not know. Therefore, she was allowed to go away, but case was booked against the daughter. But the mother was annoyed with the confinement in the Lewis & Co., that is John Lewis & Co., and she filed a case against the shop owners. But the court held that the shop owners are not liable, as they were justified in detaining her till they arrived at the police. They did not interrogate her. They did not check her belongings. They waited for the arrival of the police. Just, so you have to wait till the arrival of the police. You can't take them to the police station, or the police are not expected to immediately. They are not. They do not have any rockets. So it is justifiable, not a case of false imprisonment. Okay. Now another case, Heard versus Viro, 1915. So here what happened is, in this Viral mining, is a mining company, Heard went down in the lift. Then while doing work, he was a quarrel with the manager and he wanted to give away, but the lift did not come. It came only as a scheduled time. So since he was imprisoned there, he had filed a case. But of course, it is not allowed, because it is treated as voluntary non-fitting. Yeah, you yourself know the timings when the lift will come. For your person, single person, the lift will not come. So it cannot be false imprisonment. Now you know what are the remedies. Remedy, self-help. That means if there is an escape route, definitely you can escape. Second is habeas corpus. According to, of course, when your fundamental rights are violated, you can tap the doors of the Supreme Court on Article 32 or the High Court on Article 226 of the Constitution of India, writ of habeas corpus. Habeas corpus means have the body or produce the body before me. Third one is action for damages. As for tort law is concerned, if you think it is a tort case, definitely you can file a case for damages, right? So this is briefly regarding false imprisonment. Thank you very much.